Very good morning to you all, my dear students. Welcome back for the session of 29. Once again, this is Dr. Prasanna T, all the way from Government First Aid Women's College, Shumaga. Today, I am going to discuss in this session on the topic methods of job analysis. In previous session that we discussed about many important concepts, particularly techniques of job analysis, the significance of job analysis, and also the components of job analysis that we discussed in the previous sessions. And also we discussed about what is all about the definitions and then meaning of job analysis. Today it is a very important concept to study for the purpose of to get more knowledge and also for the purpose of the examination. Let us see that how the methods are going to derive under job analysis. There are mainly three categories as classified. Before that, I am going to mention the methods of job analysis. Let me say few words about that, how the analysis of job has been done by human resource manager. Because if human resource manager not having a proper human resource planning, I don't think so that he will categorically is going to follow the methods and also components of job analysis. But here the factor is that while making the analysis of job, human resource manager under an organization or the company, he must always looking the forward of the requirement of manpower, which is the qualitative and then quantitative as well. Here in this session that I want to give more concentration on the methods of job analysis. Here job analysis methods can be categorized into three basic types. One is observation method, and then second one is interview method, and then third one is questionnaire method. Let us come back for the previous slides. That is, I am going to elaborate giving examples that what it is all about the observation method. Okay, one by one let me discuss and then find out how we are going to derive these methods, and then how an organization or the companies are going to use these types of method while analyzing the jobs, particularly under human resource management. First one, observation method. Observation of work activities and worker behaviors is a method of job analysis which can be used independently or in combination with other methods of job analysis. Three methods of job analysis based on observation are, I mentioned there again, the further under observation method, there are three methods with the three analysis or three technique that we are going to study. Under observation method, there are three categorically divided. Basically, number one is a direct observation we can made, and then work methods analysis, and number three is critical incident techniques. After all, analyzing basic types of methods under observation method, let us see what it is all about direct observation method. Observation method is one where the work activities and of workers' behavior of the method where there is a analysis of job can be used independently while the combination of the other methods while we consider in an organization or in the industries, or you may call it as in the company. Under observation method, first one I want to discuss, that is direct observation. Using direct observation, a person conducting the analysis simply observes employees in the performance of their duties. The observer either takes general notes or works from a form which has structured categories for comment. Everything is observed, what the worker accomplishes, what equipment is used, etc. The limitation of this method is that it cannot be capture the mental aspect of the jobs such as decision making or planning, since mental process are not observable. This is one interesting issue that I want to discuss here. That is, under observation method, direct observation has to be taken into consideration for the purpose of to analyze the employee. While that human resource manager recruiting the employees, after all, that he is going to follow the employee's attitude, behavior, and then performance of his duties as well. Because nonetheless, if he is going to wasting of time in his duty allotted by the workforce according to the an organization, the employee must adhere to his work and then do that duties accordingly. The observers gives in the form of making a little bit of questions and also taking comments out of his structured categories. Everything is should be observed, not only the worker works, where there is accomplishment of and what type of equipment he is using in his work. Everything, the property that how much he is using in his work is going to analyze while in the job analysis. This is what the direct observation all together we will consider. This only drawback of this direct observation method is that in under this method, one could not able to get observation of what actually thing is going on in the mindset of the employee. One could not able to find out the process what actually going on the employee mind. The decision making or you may call it as a planning is also tough task to find out under this direct observation method. But this is one type of observation method that which will derives the employee's attitude or mental process are not to be observable under direct observation. The second one is work method analysis under observation method is what it is all about. Let us see. This method is used to describe manual and repetitive production jobs such as factory or you may call it as assembling line jobs. This is very important to be concerned because there are such types of repetitive production maybe happening in the jobs. To reduce these types of repetitive or doubling of production level, using this work methods analysis and such repetitive production may reduce. In factories and then assembling line jobs, we may find out this analysis, that is work methods, which will be described manually, not through online or not through network or not through any under computer system. This is only done by manually, particularly from that organization. This method is used by industrial engineers to determine standard rates of production. So as I said earlier, the work method analysis supposed to use in industrial people, particularly those who are working as engineers, they will determine using this work method analysis only to see the standard rates of production, whether that production is qualitative or the production is quantitative. In that process, the work method analysis must used by engineers. But nonetheless, for most of the cases in private sector, particularly the large scale industries, or you may call it as medium scale industries, or the other ancillary units are also having these types of work method analysis to determine the standard rates of production. This is the second basic types of method analysis under observation method. And then number three is that critical incidents technique under observation method, which involves observation and recording of examples. I want to give it here, particularly effective or ineffective behavior of that employee. Behaviors are judged to be effective or ineffective in terms of results produced by the behavior. In this method, a person using the critical incident must describe behavior in a retrospect way, not a prospective way, but it is in a retrospect way. The retrospect means the previous one, or after the fact rather than as the activity unfolds. Accurate recording of past observations is more difficult than recording the behaviors as they occur. See, this one is a very good technique under observation method, because critical incidents technique are to use under this recording of examples of the particular, say for example, behavior, whether it is effective or ineffective in nature, particularly from that employee, while getting result of production level under industries. Critical incident techniques is a person using a critical behavior retrospectively, and at the same time where the activities is unfold. If it is activities are fold, I don't think so that rectification are going to be made out. If it is unfold, definitely the chances to get a little bit of rectification, particularly from that employee through human resource manager, which will increase the effective of behavior of that employee, and also effectiveness in organization may also increase. This is what the third critical incident technique that we discussed in the observation method. Moving on to the second slide, where the main category of methods of job analysis that we find, that is interview method. This method is a very important method to analyze the job, particularly in human resource management. In this method, the analyst interviews the employee, his supervisor and other concerned persons, and record answers to relevant questions. The interview asks the job related questions, and a standard format has to be set out, which will use it to record the data. The limitation of this method is that it does not provide accurate information, because the employee may not provide accurate information to protect his own interest. Success of this method depends upon the rapport between the analyst and the employee. Yeah, in this method, let me give many examples for interview method, because interview method is one where a good rapport has to be developed by an employee and then an organization. But this method we are going to use not only in industries, but also somehow in the colleges or in government sector, or it may be in the private sector while recruiting and then selecting the employee. There should be one type of rapport should be developed from that analyst, who is the the enumerator of this interview, or you may call it as who is the analyzer of this interview method. He will also supervise by getting interview of that employee by providing some of the questions which is related to the employee jobs. Employee job relating to that question, he may have a little bit of hide and seek in his work nature, he may hidden the something while doing the work, particularly from that employee. So in this method we may not get the accurate information, particularly from that employee to analyst. So recognizing the quality and then quantity of that work from that employee may not be may not be considered, at the same time may not be identified from this interview method. But in this method there should be a good relationship maybe increase between analyst and then employee is happened. But this is one type of method that what actually we are observed under job analysis, because analysis of job is a tough ask. At the same time we are using this method to do job analysis. Our last one is questionnaire method. Number 3 is questionnaire method. Categorically it is categorized that questionnaire method is one method to analyze the job. What it is all about actually? In this method, properly drafted questionnaires are sent to job holders. Structured questionnaires on different aspects of a job are developed. Each task is described in terms of characteristics such as frequencies, significance, difficulty, and relationship to overall performance. The job holders give their rating of these dimensions. The rating obtained or analyzed and a profile of actual job is developed. This method provides comprehensive information about a job. The limitation of this method is that it is a time consuming and costlier one, particularly in an organization or in the company. This is one best method actually if the analyst number are more in that management, because a certain amount of questions should be prepared by the analyst which will be supplied to the job holders. Job holders means already they got job recruited or they already selected to the company. They will supplied this questionnaire with the bunch of a book, or you may call it as a brochure, or you may call it as a handbook, and then they will supply the containing many questions. At the same time there are many questions will be appear on the basis of variables, frequencies, and then significance of the job, what actually is doing in this the work force according to the organization, and then difficulty level in the work, and then overall performance, and then what type of relationship they are having with organization and with the company. The job holders give their rating according to the, say for example, average to medium to large, or you may call it as agree, disagree, or not agree, strong, strongly agreed. Like that they will ranging from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that they will rating the questions according to the dimensions. The rating of obtained or analyzed and a profile of actual job is developed, particularly under this questionnaire method. But there is a concept that is comprehensive information about this job will provided by this method. That is what the welcoming aspect, particularly in questionnaire method. But in this method we are facing one drawback, or you may call it as one limitation, that is it is most costlier and it is most time consuming method, because supplying questionnaire method all over to the employee in that particular organization, and then job, and then collecting the questionnaire, and then making coding and then decoding of that answers, it could be tough as for analyst as well. But this is one limitation that I want to mention here, that time consuming and then costly is the two factors that which will draw back the questionnaire method. And also this is one type of limitation that what actually I want to mention here in the questionnaire method. So many companies and then organization are also following these types of questionnaire method. So I will stop here, dear students. These are all the methods that what actually we categorized into three basic types. One is observation method, and then second one is interview method, and then number three is what you call the questionnaire method. All three methods used by human resource manager in their organization or in their company, either it may be in public sector or it may be in the private sector, both are same or not the same, because analysis of the job is not a quite different issue, but it is a tough ask. Following all these methods may be easy to analyze the job, because the nature of job, and then when you are going to consider the scope of job, when we are going to have the significance of job, it's not a joke, dear students. This is what I want to tell in this way. But this is what are the methods that the analyst is going to follow. The methods, that is observation method. Under that observation method, I also discussed about direct observation, work method analysis, critical incident techniques. So last two and three are interview method and then questionnaire method. So with this, I will stop here, my dear students. The last slide, as I told in the previous sessions, that I collected all the information, and also I depended these sources as a reference, particularly Dr. S. Ganesan, Leon C. McGinson, and also Deshpande Squires. I want to say the Deshpande Squire, because the Geeta S. D. Deshpande and then Deshpande Smita are the one family members. Okay, so Deshpande Squires, I want to mention. This book is a wonderful book, dear students. Please follow that book titled Human Resource Management, published by Nirali Prakashan. With this, I will stop here. I will come up with a new topic, a new session. For now, bye for now. Thank you very much.